my channel. I am so happy you decided to click this video. So for today, I thought I would do something kind of simple. I will be doing a kind of voiceover tutorial using the Colourpop and Sailor Moon palette. This is being restocked on the 27th. Today that I'm filming this, it is the 26th. So hopefully I'll be able to have this up on the 27th. I've had this palette since it first launched. I was one of the lucky ones that was able to snag the entire collection before it sold out. So I have already played with this. This is an eye look that I've come up with a couple months ago. But I thought since, you know, I didn't have a YouTube a couple months ago and now I do, that I would try and just recreate the look that I had originally played around with. Now, not in the tutorial are these like moon and stars. I kind of thought last minute it'd be fun just to add them. For some reason I feel like the moon looks like a banana, but whatever, you're supposed to have fun with makeup. So also don't know what's going on with my hair today. It's a wash day and it's looking terrible. So if you're interested in the look that I come up with, this one right here, this colorful look using the new Sailor Moon and Colourpop collection, then just keep on watching.
Alright, first voiceover tutorial. Whoop whoop. So I've already gone ahead and done my eyebrows. I am not good at eyebrows, so please don't judge me too harshly on that. And I went ahead already and primed my eyes with the Anastasia Beverly Hills primer because I really wanted a white base to help the colors pop a little bit more. And there's what the palette looks like. It's so gorgeous. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start out with the shade Justice, which is that yellow shade right there. And you can see that it is a very pigmented shadow. And what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just stamp that color into my inner corner, kind of bringing it up a third of the way there. I'm not going to blend anything out just yet. I just want to stamp the color on first to make sure I get the maximum pigmentation. Alright, so I ended up blending out the outer corners just a little bit, and what I'm going to be doing now is just taking the second shade, which is Tuxedo Rose right there, a gorgeous peachy pink shade, and I'm going to be stamping it onto my crease just like I did with the yellow, and then after that I will begin to blend it into the yellow. You will see that I will dip into both colors just to help get a nice blend going. Alright, now that I have them blended out to my liking, it's looking pretty good. I'm going to go into the third shade, which is Love right there, a little bit of a deeper pink shade, and I'm just going to blend it into that lighter peachy shade. Again, with all the steps, I'm just going to be stamping the color on just to make sure that I get the maximum pigmentation for each shadows, because I really want this eye look to pop. It's a very colorful, bright, fun look. This palette definitely represents Sailor Moon in my eyes, and yeah. Alright, so this shade doesn't need too much blending, as you'll see. It's a very beautiful shade. So now I'm going to be dipping into the fourth shade right there, which is Miracle Romance, that purple. And I'm gonna be again stamping the color on. This time I'm going to wing out the purple and then also bring the purple into an angle onto my eyelid. Now you will see this color does take a little bit more work to build up. It's not as pigmented as the other shadows, but it is still a beautiful color once you do get it worked out. Alright, so since this shade is taking a little bit of time to, build up and blend out, I just thought I would say a giant hello and welcome to my channel to all the new subscribers that I've gained since I posted Jeffree Star's new nude collection that came out. I wasn't expecting to get all those subscribers, and I want to thank you guys for doing that. I just love makeup. You know, I'm not a professional makeup artist and I'm not claiming to be. This is all just for fun and in my free time. So thank you guys for the support. Welcome to the channel. In the comments down below, tell me about yourself. What's your favorite color? Where are you guys from? Your favorite food? Anything like that. And just a big thank you to everybody that's watched the Jeffree Star video. I just never thought I would have that many views on a video. So it's pretty wild. So thank you guys so much. And I hope to hear from you guys soon. I hope you like this tutorial too. So. So I've just taken each individual shade and I've just blended it out, just kind of softening up that line so they're a little more blended out. I did end up taking the colors just a little too high up, so there was a very small gap in between my eyebrows and the eyeshadow, so I'm just going in with like a typical white shade. Honestly, you could just use any palette for this one. There wasn't a white shade in this palette, so I dipped into another, but I'm just kind of highlighting my brow bone here and also helping to bring the color down on my eyes just a little bit so it doesn't look too high up, if that makes sense. I find this also helps me blend out the harsh lines on the colors too, so. So now I'm just cutting my crease using the Anastasia Beverly Hills primer again, just because it has that white base and I just love cutting my crease for this. Again, I'm very new to cut creasing, so it's not going to be all the best. Please go easy on me, just a little bit. And does anybody ever hold their breath when cutting their crease? Because I'm pretty much not breathing at this point. Thank you. All right, so I've cut my crease to the best of my abilities. And now first I started off going with into Silver Millennium, that Super Shock shade right there. I tried to use my finger. As you can see, there's pigmentation on my finger. But once I tried to swipe and pat it on, there was absolutely no reflect or color payoff to it. I think the one downside to this palette is that shade. I don't know if I'm using it wrong or what. I don't know if this shade has a learning curve, because I do have Super Shock shadows from Colourpop that I don't have this problem with. So instead I just went into Silver Crystal, which is that pink shade there. It's an absolutely gorgeous shade, loved it. I went in with a wet brush to really amplify it. I didn't have any problems with this shade at all. You'll see that I also went back into Silver Millennium and just tapped it on to Silver Crystal just to give it more of a gold kind of reflect to it. That's honestly the only way I could get that Super Shock shade to work for me or have any type of effect on my eyes, I guess, if you will. So please let me know in the comments down below if I'm using it wrong or what. So all right, so I just placed the shimmer shade onto my lid and kind of put the purple more of a kind of angle, almost like a wing. But now I'm gonna go in with a liquid liner. This is Colourpop's BFF liner. It's just in a plain black, nothing special. And I'm just gonna line my eyes into a cat eye shape. I kept telling myself not to go bigger, but I kept messing up and just kept adding more. So it kind of turned into a pretty big wing towards the end. And after that, I'm gonna be adding mascara. This is the Tarte something. I can't remember the name. I think it's like Flash Camera Action or something mascara. I'm not sure. I just had it right on my desk, so I just decided to pop that on. You'll see after that I just decided to put on some lashes and smoke out the purple shade, the pink shade, and the yellow shade onto my lower lashes just to add a little something to it. Shadow turns to sun rays and on and on. All right, guys, so I just popped on those Calla lashes that I got from Marshall's. They were only $3 and they look so freaking good. I absolutely love them. But this is what the eye looks like. I'm gonna go ahead and pop on the other eye and we will do a final reveal of the eye look. But as you can see, that's pretty much what we're going for with this eye there. And that was the tutorial using the Colourpop and Sailor Moon collection. I'm not going to go too in-depth with this because it's been out for so long, so I'm pretty sure you guys have seen the reviews on it, but I really love this palette. I really love the theme. It hits home for me. I love Sailor Moon. It's always going to be a huge part of my childhood. I do hope to see more Sailor Scout collections come out, one for each of them. I would absolutely love that. I am wearing one of the blushes and the blotted lips. I am wearing the blush from the moon on my cheeks right there. I just finished up the rest of my face because I wanted this to be more focused on the eyeshadow palette, but I am wearing that on my cheeks. I absolutely love ColourPop blushes. I highly recommend picking this up if you can, even getting some backups if you already have it. They are just so good. So pigmented and blendable, absolutely gorgeous on the skin. And then I am wearing the blotted lip in the shade Bunhead, which is this one here, as well as the lip gloss, which is Moon Tiara, which is that kind of very light peach shade. So I am wearing that on my face. I just use one of the Milani Fruit Fetish liners, the yellow one, just to draw the stars on there. Nothing special as far as that, but this is the finished eye look for today. Don't forget to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Comment down below what you think of the collection, if you bought the collection, if you're buying backups tomorrow or today, I guess, depending on when I upload this, and who your favorite Sailor Scout is. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel down below to be notified when I upload, and I will see you guys in the next one. All right, have a great day. Bye.